I've done a lot of research on both sides of the AI art controversy, and I think I'm in the best position to talk about this issue because I'm not particularly passionate about drawing. I like creating and experimenting with brushes, features, art styles, processes, and telling a story more than the process of drawing a masterpiece, which is why I make webtoons. I like seeing speed paints because they don't feel frustrating, and if you know me, you know how obsessed I am with speed and efficiency. So I always thought AI art was going to be extremely useful to me by generating images from my own works. But obviously that's not what has happened to the art industry. AI image generators could have been an excellent tool if they didn't scrape every piece of imagery off the internet to sell a product to non-artists who then sold the generated images to people buying them. I don't think you should be feeding other people's work into the AI at all. At least, personally, I don't want to produce artwork that I'm not capable of producing, and I also don't want to copy the art styles of other artists whether I look up to them or not. What I don't understand specifically is 1. How companies are legally allowed to create AI art programs, how they are able to use the images that they don't have the rights to in their program and commercialize it. This guy explains it as a legal loophole that allows AI companies to exploit an underdeveloped field in terms of copyright law, and one that has no risk of being sued by corporate businesses because artists don't have the same protections that musicians, for example, under labels have.
Corporations monopolize it. They try to get away with everything they can ethically before the law catches up with them, by which time they are well-established leaders in their field. And the stupid thing is, out of all of this, this situation could have been avoided if these AI were just trained right. On Creative Commons material, or stuff in the public domain, or artwork volunteered by people who wanted to help, even if it still managed to create art a little like Sam Yang's, this would not be the same ethical issue. How do I know that? Because we've done it before. With Dance Diffusion, a program built to generate music from purely public domain, volunteered, or licensed material that nobody really has an issue with. Nobody's work is stolen, and it's not facilitating theft. And you know what the most ridiculous thing is? Dance Diffusion was developed by the same people as Stable Diffusion. The people who are facilitating all of this in the art world. It might be difficult to fathom how such incredible hypocrisy exists within the same company because they insisted that it's really important that they not infringe on copyright. The music industry is extremely prone to suing over its intellectual property, partly because it is dominated by these huge media conglomerates with a lot of money and power. Art, on the other hand, is far more decentralized, made up of millions of independent actors who could not levy the same resources against them. And they made a calculation. It was far more profitable and with far less risk to steal people's work and feed it into the machine in the art world than it was in the music one.
The audacity of them to even charge money in exchange for a tool they developed with intellectual property they don't even own, that's like if a game company took individual 3D assets from other games without knowledge, consent, and compensation, and generated a combination to make a new game, and did that with every part of the game like story and sold it to people. Sure, as a whole, that game is different from any one game you took assets from, but exact replicas of parts of that game were still not made by your employees, meaning you had no right to use. How is this different from what humans have already been doing? When you as a human plagiarize an essay in college, you get expelled. You combining the exact phrases of others into a new combination does not make it not plagiarism. You shouldn't be able to do that in any industry. 2. Why is AI artist a job? How do people have an unethical and borderline soon to be illegal career teaching others to do the same? And the fact that there are so many people wanting to learn and join just baffles me. I guess it's because they don't want to put the time into learning a skill set they clearly want to know if they have to use AI programs, but they just want other people to do the work for them without having to pay them so that they can save their own time and money while negatively impacting others in the process. But of course, they still want to pay the AI company because it's cheaper for the individual but mass sales for the company. AI art doesn't exist, so I'll just call it AI composition, and AI artists also don't exist, so I'll just call them AI users or AI commissioners. Upon research, it seems like AI characters or compositions are created through trial and error, which is the work that the AI users claim they are putting in, trying to generate a product that is pleasing to their eye by typing in the desired commands or prompts, hoping that after so many times of composition variations, the result would be close to what they had in mind, because they don't don't actually have a creative choice. Their options are limited to the already existing database of copyrighted artwork. And although the image generator is not collaging artworks together, the copyrighted works were used to train the generator to be able to recognize shapes, patterns, concepts, and values, which is theft, possibly illegal due to it being commercial despite not having licensed the materials used. But this is what an AI user means when they say my art, or that they created or built the product. Once you generate a composition enough times and feed the AI the new compositions and do that over again to narrow the variations down, you might just reach consistency. Your characters aren't consistent because you're not creating them. What the fuck is this? It's not creating what you desire because you're not creating it. It's like a random character hair customization button after you choose the race, class, and hair length in a game, and it generates more like Clip Studio Paint's head models. There's 9 designs, but we can get way more variations because we can combine them or merge them together. And yet I still can't use these models because I can't get them to look like the head I already created. The AI has 5 billion designs, so you have a lot more choices, but the prompt still works sort of like a filter. You're not going to get it to look as you desire because you're limited to the combinations of those options. You still call your game character my character because you made it, as in you chose from the options, but do you own your character or the head model? No, the company does. Why? Because the designers that made the design options available to you work for the company. They were paid to make the game. Your options as an AI user were made available to you by the people who were not paid. You wouldn't even have a design issue if you weren't trying to create AI compositions. To create a combined illustration, they do the trial and error process with every subject and mix and match and insert them into a composition. It's not a direct collage, but a collage of images generated with countless copyrighted works. Do you really think God would have supported this? Nothing is completely original. Everything is inspired by everything. So an idiot might ask, how is AI composition different from artists using references? 1. Human creations are references plus your own creativity plus perception, while AI is references plus references. Actually, you can't even use the word reference for AI because when an artist refers to something, it's not this is. There is a difference in the way every human perceives that derives from experiences, personality, and existence. Humans cannot automatically replicate patterns, shapes, color values, and concepts exactly as they are, like machines do, so even with the same references used, the results will turn out different. And I think there is a part in a lot of human beings, I don't know about all human beings due to how NPC many of you act, but there is a part of you that is not influenced by your surrounding environment, which in this case are all the human creations we saw before we made our own. It's the part of you that decided how to take in information before information was ever told to you. The way we process information from the very start differs because that's not something you're told how to do, which is why two humans who grow up in the same environment can develop extremely different personalities. We're born with certain inner traits regarding information processing that usually don't change, which I believe is what our default creativity is. What I'm saying is that you can have a wider range of creativity by experiencing more, but the way you process the new experiences is usually not going to change, and even if it does, it will still be different from anyone else. Especially for things like character design, artists create costume designs or parts of a being that didn't exist before. 2. No artist solely uses another artist's work to figure out how to draw something, okay? Let's make that clear. Unless it's fan art, you refer to the real subject to figure out how to draw it, and the result is in realism or your own style. Of course, there are extents to this, like if you're trying to figure out how to draw monsters that don't exist in real life, you're going to have to refer to real-life animals and creations by other artists. And obviously, artists who use the exact same references to create a character design is not going to be able to come up with the same result. No artist copies another artist's piece exactly as it is, unless it's dinosaurs, which then I have to copy this dude, but meanwhile, AI is fed exact replicas of creative artwork to generate new combinations using that data because it is not capable of creativity, which is why someone else can generate your AI composition using the same prompts. That's like if I only used other people's work to create my work. I tried it just to show you what I'm talking about. Of course, I used AI images that people already generated and not real artists' work. What you do copy, though, is the idea, like, that's a cool idea, I should make something like that one day, or you copy the saturation, contrast certain parts of the creation process, like the type of brush they use or the layer modes, or you try out glazing after seeing someone else do it. Or you copy the tools they use, certain ways to apply lighting, or draw a body part. And if you do copy someone's art style to create your own works for the purpose of stealing or using their style in general and not just to study the processes for research purposes, you get cancelled, and even the research purpose is a little bit on thin ice because 1, you might unintentionally adapt their art style by intentionally copying them for a purpose. purpose, and two, some people are fine with it, but others will never even think to do it. So let's not pretend like humans completely capable of learning how to draw that are using existing artwork to sell products without permission or compensation before it gets regulated is the democratization of art. And this is consistent with the law because as of mid-March, AI compositions are not eligible for copyright protection. Anyone can use images generated without human creativity. A graphic novel's words were able to be copyrighted, but the individual AI images were not, which means anyone can use those images. And this all means that you have to be an artist to be an AI artist. You can't only use works from other people, you're also going to have to learn how to draw, unless you're going to add some other element, like writing. As you probably already know, there are lawsuits going on that is artists versus AI companies. 3 months ago, Stability AI, Midjourney, and DeviantArt asked a San Francisco federal court to dismiss the class action lawsuit because the generated images were not similar to the original works of plaintiff Sarah Anderson, the specific images used to train the models were not identified by the artist, and that you can't prove that the images were used to train the models in the first place. The artists would have lost, but last month, Judge William Oreck allowed them to refile a better complaint with evidence backing it up, saying it's difficult to believe that the plaintiff's works were involved in the creation of the AI programs, even though you can literally type in her name in a prompt to generate her style of work, so the AI had to have learned from her works to be able to do so. But just the fact that the AI can imitate her style is not enough because at the moment, there's no substantial similarity between hers and the AI's, which makes sense because countless images were used in addition to hers for this very purpose of it being unrecognizable to any one image used. So she would have to prove that her images were used to train the AI, but how would the plaintiffs have direct evidence of that? I don't think that's something you can prove without inside sources from those companies because they're definitely not going to reveal the materials they use to train their AI. But the fact that the AI is able to produce a certain style regardless of close similarity by inputting the author's name means that it is able to trace back to the specific sources associated with her name, which is evidence in itself that the AI has seen her works before. Another article on the same topic reports that the plaintiffs should be able to provide more facts because they have Stability's source code, so this makes a lot more sense. I don't get why it's implausible that the artist's work were involved when the systems have been trained on 5 billion compressed images, their works being images. But okay, this makes sense why the generated images need to be upscaled and quality sharpened all the time. As for the question, are AI companies responsible for many individuals potentially violating copyright laws using their program? The fact that people can search artists' names to replicate their style instead of commissioning them means that the program links artists with their work used to create the program, and this enables theft or at least makes it incredibly easy for people to do so, and certainly doesn't promote them or their revenue. But one might say these models that replicate a specific artist's style were trained by unethical individuals. However, you can't expect the users who use the original program despite knowing the systems were made unethically to use the program ethically. You're attracting the same kinds of people that made the AI program. It's funny that this article is on Microsoft's Dart because Microsoft is also involved in an AI copyright lawsuit. It states that you can find out if your works have been used to train AI by typing your name in the website Have I Been Trained, which searches the database Lion that AI companies use. I guess this is proof of specific images that AI companies used to train their AI, so hopefully the artist have a chance at their lawsuit because it also seems like a privacy breach. To opt out of your images used on Lion, you need to create an account, and from then on, I suppose they track you, share your information to for-profit data companies, and indirectly sell your personal information instead of your art. It's funny coming from a tech company that your information is not safe with them, and that they will use your information to train more AI, but this is not considered selling your information. Instead, they're probably going to sell the AI that used your information for free, which I suppose is GPT. I love how they say it's not considered to be selling and not just it is not selling. They know people are going to have a problem with this. Legal changes due to AI are not just happening in the US, as there is no precedent yet. The EU AI Act proposes that AI tools disclose any copyrighted material used to train their systems, which will make it evident that they used copyright material for profit. This law later passed, according to an article from yesterday as of recording, which more people disliked than liked for whatever reason. Clearly, AI users or commissioners are upset that they may not be able to exploit in the future. A comment saying, "The tables can be easily turned against all these artists wanting compensation from these AI technologies. Ask any and every artist this one question. Have you ever looked at images or art at an art gallery or museum? Well, all the artist's works you enjoyed and marveled over, you then went back to your art studio and made paintings in the style of Renoir or Picasso, etc. You made paintings and art that you stole from earlier artists of the 17th, 18th, 19th, 20th, 21st centuries. These artists are mad that everyday people can now create any art they please without them. You should go say that in court. See how they react if you ever want to feel bad about yourself, because you did say the tables could easily be turned. I'm not gonna repeat what I said earlier in the video, and as for stealing, who the fuck copies Renoir and Picasso? Renoir is just realism. His brush strokes are unique, obviously, but these are generally what pieces look like when you're copying the world. As for Picasso, I'm not into contemporary, so I can't really speak on that, but aren't the most searched artists on AI systems artists like these, whose art looks nothing like back in the day? You're comparing artists who've been dead for a while to ones alive now. I'm sure if all these past artists were alive, they wouldn't like you stealing their art. And I say steal because if artists are stealing from other artists, then what the fuck are you doing? You're not even drawing or painting or doing any work to create. You're not creating without artists, you're creating thanks to them. Your AI would not exist without existing artwork. Artists can get inspired by and reference other artists, but you're not an artist. What makes you entitled to use their works to express yourself for profit or clout? And of course, Discord allows all this. If you didn't know, Midjourney is a Discord bot. Discord that had a privacy breach worse than Facebook in the past and has only added more because they have almost no end-to-end encryption. So many people have been trying to register AI-generated images at the copyright office that the copyright law had to change, which is incredible hypocrisy. Imagine attempting to claim images built on stolen artworks. So the law updated in March, and yet YouTubers are still telling people to sell AI compositions that are not significantly modified. Call me crazy, but are you allowed to sell works that you don't own the rights to? Hey guys, look at this underrated AI image generator. How can plagiarism be underrated, am I right? And it's free too. Of course it's free, they didn't pay to use any of the images used for their generator. The reason why so many AI generators are releasing is because everything about it is so easy. You can make something out of nothing but an empty system using billions of assets you didn't have to pay for, so it's low risk, high return, small investment but large profit because exploitation is in high demand. Why make the world better when you can make it worse?
You'd need to use your own brilliant brain here to figure out all of the steps and skills involved, but there's a lot of potential here to make much more than a traditional 9-to-5 income. Plus, there's a lot of room here for scaling a larger Shopify brand that you might be able to sell one day.
Your brilliant own brain to type in prompts and edit in Photoshop? Are you kidding me? You're worried about the livelihood of brands who have no care for the livelihood of artists. When copyright laws somewhat protect the livelihood of artists now, imagine defending people for using works that they don't own for commercial purposes. Did the definition of doodling change? People are under the impression that the art style a program produces is its own style. It's a combination of the styles of artists, so let's just call it our style. It has to force that style onto the products because those are the styles from the database. Why is that even a complaint? You chose to use the program instead of drawing yourself. AI programs produce different styles, probably because the trained images or the regulation of generated results are different. The company makes it so that their results produce a specific aesthetic or style, which honestly makes it worse in terms of enabling theft. A group of so-called artists are bullying AI artists like me, claiming images generated by Midjourney belongs to them. This is a false statement and a lie. They're doing organized attacks to my channel, full of hate and insulting my content. It doesn't necessarily belong to Midjourney either. Video game companies have been banning AI commissioners from joining because of these legal complications, and I'm assuming this dude removes his comments because no one is attacking him. I want to be the only one who is able to see my work. works. What was interesting to me after watching too many videos is you're supposed to disclaim that you used AI for your shops or commissions, right? Not a single AI supporting video mentions that. So I guess it's time to glaze and watermark our images. If you want to use AI programs for your creative process, use ones like Firefly that supposedly gathers non-copyrighted images. Firefly is by Adobe, so they will probably make it a $300 subscription, but who knows? As I was searching for opinions on whether or not we should watermark artwork to be protected from AI companies, I came across this discussion of AI commissioners putting watermarks on AI-generated work. Guess I feel kind of like a fraud claiming it, but then again, it takes some skill and ability to produce art. I'm sorry, what? Skill and ability? If you can't claim that you have those traits and be an AI user, it's called art because it was taken from art, not because you produced it. It seems somewhat disingenuous for me to sign a work created by AI. It did the creating, but on the other hand, I was the
impetus,
selector of options, and curator of the final result. So in a way, my human input is ultimately what drew the final image out from a mass of data which the application's designers had amassed. I don't think designers picked out certain pieces to use for their 5 billion image collections. The data amassed were other people's artwork that the company had not licensed, so how can you claim the result as yours? The AI did not generate this out of thin air on its own, so it must be me who created it, of course, because it takes some skill and patience to create nice images, so give me the credit. Can anyone do it? Of course, with the time anyone can pretty much do anything, but that's not the discussion. That is the discussion. If by time you mean 30 seconds, anyone can create what you did with the same prompt and application because you didn't create it. It does not take skill and patience to create nice images out of nice images because you didn't do anything but send messages. I think a text conversation would be longer than the prompts. Which brings up another point I didn't understand, which is why people do this in the first place. Originally, I thought, how incompetent, lazy, and insecure do you have to be to use replicas of other people's work to earn income instead of doing anything else productive for society? Is your own work not desirable to yourself or anyone else for you to have to use other people's talent to pass off as your own because it's better than anything you could ever do, or do you just want to make money in the easiest way possible? Like, what was your job before this? Or are you all high school graduates who don't want to do any work to learn anything before making money? And if you're just trying to pick the easiest way out because you can't land a job, that's very unfortunate that you can't land a job, but do you have to invest in exploitation to overcome the defeatist mindset? Especially when a lot of these AI commissioners somehow feel superior to artists, with the sentiment that being an artist is not a real job and that they should get a real job, claiming that when AI generators improve, artists are no longer going to be needed because AI compositions look better than art. But how ignorant do you have to be to think that artists should also be AI commissioners instead? If artists moved on to AI compositions, we would both lose our jobs, you idiot. You have to use other people's talent because you have no talent of your own. The only reason you make money is because other people are unintentionally drawing for you. When all the talented people move on to doing nothing like you are, you're not going to have any talent to use. You need artists to exist for you to exist. Their art is the only reason you have your job, so you should be supporting them for your own good. And you don't realize that because I guess the human brain is not as brilliant as this guy says. Some of these people were laid off or semi-retired. Nobody will hire them and they're done working for others, so now they want other people to work for them. I'm sure there's a more ethical way for you to make money, like teaching other people the skills from your impressive resume if you're not going to use them anyway. This is just a means to an income. These AI commissioners just want to make money easily by taking advantage of the people who made the method possible. Like, watch this guy complain about the time it takes for him to run prompts when it probably took 9 hours on average for each art piece.
And you don't deal with anything, you don't fulfill orders, you don't do anything at all, okay? This is the most passive way of making money. This is a completely different level of passiveness. You don't do anything. Also, Etsy doesn't support return policy on digital products. You can't return a digital product. And this is why this is amazing. And AI is only making it smoother and easier because now you can make this product very easy. There's one major con that is bothering me. It can take quite some time to create one bundle of AI art that you want to sell on Etsy. Some bundles that I created took me anything from like 20 minutes to an hour or more.
Be proud of yourself for what? It's absurdly funny how the community motivates each other as if it's some kind of feat to run props for an hour and sell the results online. And the fact that you would feel any negative emotion if that doesn't go well is insane. I suppose the encouragement is for people who think selling AI compositions are a lot of work. And if you're someone who thinks that, you probably have never worked before.
So I had to find a way to resize the art generated from Midjourney into these exact sizes. I created canvases in these exact sizes and placed my art into those canvases. Again, this was just a lot of manual work, so I tried to automate it by recording my actions in Photoshop. But this didn't work at all. I just couldn't get Photoshop to place the image into the canvases properly and have it centered and looking decent. So I just continued resizing manually and wasting a lot of time. Is selling AI art really a fluke? I don't actually think so. I mean, don't get me wrong, it's definitely not easy. It is a lot of work.
The only reason why an AI composition can look better than a single individual's art is because it combines the skill sets of every individual together. It combines masterpieces together. An artist could be pro at a specific task, like lighting, and another artist could be better than the first at color picking, and the AI composition generated from both of their works would have the best lighting and colors. If talent was genetic and you genetically engineered a human to have the best traits of its parents, the baby is going to be more talented than a single parent, with both their talents. An improved AI composition program is a combination of every artist and the best parts of them, which means it has the potential to perform every art process perfectly. You still required the parents to produce the child. Artists' work were still used to train AI programs, and the child cannot grow on its own. The parents still have to raise the child. You have to be completely delusional to consider AI commissioner a career.
So am I stopping? Not a chance.
There's also the view that learning art for years is useless and unnecessary when there's an easy way out using artists that already exist. If you're supporting AI generators because it's not worth the effort to learn how to draw, it just doesn't take years to get good at art anymore. There's tutorials everywhere, and art is one of the easiest skills to start. You only need a writing utensil and some kind of paper. I would argue that if you're thinking of getting into digital art, it's the best time to start drawing because technology has developed so much. Not in the AI generator kind of way, but actual tools for the process kind of way. You can just start easily with realism on pen and paper, learn how to use references, branch out to new styles and subjects, and use 3D assets to help with the consistency you desire so much. It's really not that hard anymore. You start with realism because you naturally develop a sense of perspective, 3D space, lighting, and anatomy. It's like at least five birds with one stone. If you suck at art, it's probably because you didn't start with realism. Art is incredibly easy if you just know how to improve. And if you're really into using other people's materials so you don't need to make your own, you can download them from artists who want you to do so. The best thing you can do is take your own reference photos or use photos you already have in your gallery so that you can copy as much as you want. I just don't think AI programs have that much worth. Midjourney's most basic plan is $10 a month, while Clip Studio Paint Pro's is $10 a year. After you buy the program, which for me was a one-time payment of $25 when it was on sale. So a year of Midjourney is $120, while a year of Clip Studio Paint Pro on Update Pass is at most $60, and the difference will only grow exponentially over time. There are plenty of free drawing programs too, although I don't know if any of them support 3D models. There is the cost of a starter drawing tablet to factor in, but it would all still cost less than Midjourney. Not to mention, all of these AI commissioners are using Photoshop, which is also subscription-based. Why in the world would you pay $20 a month to cut and paste, scale, rotate, apply gradient, and change the resolution and aspect ratio of images? In a way, I think the reason why these AI commissioners feel so entitled is because they're paying so much for a product that they think is just the next big thing, the next technological advancement, and that all of the credit goes to the company who created an empty system. And maybe the reason why they feel like it's so much work is because they're learning something new. I guess the definition of AI art now is an AI-generated image that is significantly modified enough to be registered for copyright. It's times like these that I'm glad that I don't have a set art style that people can rip off. There is value in AI composition, obviously, for people who can never learn how to draw in the first place, for example, but they obviously don't need to use unethical AI programs for that. Artists can also boost their efficiency by sourcing a model using only their images, though I don't know how that would be regulated. I would probably use AI that uses stock photos for the purpose of using stock photos for YouTube videos or something. It seemed like the best idea to me at this moment. My hope is that every AI image generator defaults opt artists out and we have to choose to opt in, and that when we do choose to opt in, the generator gives credit to these artists. Because honestly, this whole situation has tainted the industry so much. Not that I ever had faith in humanity, but AI composition is also part of the reason why I don't only want to do art content. It's very limiting to stay in one field, in the likely case that your field inevitably gets bombarded.